want to talk about what is Oman's unique role in global politics, that being a mediator between the US and Iran. And this predates the revolution, of course, in 1979, but most recently hosting talks between Washington and Tehran. There is a deadline for a political deal at the end of March. Are you optimistic that will be met?
I am optimistic that they're going to strike a deal, whether in March or in July, the deal is going to be, because this is gives benefits for everyone. And you should understand, if they don't reach a deal, what is the alternative? And this deal is the only deal of its kind that happens in the past. It will not allow in the future a crisis of this kind. This is the strong wall between stability and crisis.
So you've been as close to these talks as anybody. There are those who say that Iran and the US should talk together and leave P5 plus one out of this. Do you agree?
No.
Why not?
Because this is it's not bilateral matter. It's an international concern. United States probably the the most member who is more concerned of the proliferation of the nuclear. But without United Nations and all world support this this agreement, to be should be an agreement with which no one would have any reservation.
You've talked about the alternative being not something we should consider. If these talks don't work, how will that affect Oman's relations with the US and or relations with Tehran? Which are more important to you?
First, I don't think either of those two parties is for any moment thinking of the alternatives. They're going straight forward to strike a deal. That is what it is. We are not taking side at all. We are trying to facilitate the both sides with what we think it is good for them.
If you were to describe the Oman doctrine to me, what is it?
What we're doing now is that we want to see this region and other region in peace. We have been in wars for many times. I mean, for the last three or four decades, it's war after war, war after war, war after war. This has to be disappeared.